All right, everyone. I have no idea what's going to happen here, but Medion needs to be away from it with his unfortunate little paralysis and so on. Yeah, so actually today I have just had my final exam in what I hope is the second to final study course in university, so three cheers for that. I thought I would actually sit down and play some shard light or something instead, but well, it's Shining Force. What can I say? Now I'm in a slight bit of predicament here. Now I think, well, the impression I get from the guide I'm following, which could be entirely inaccurate, is that when I kill either of the two bosses, the whole battle will end. That would be pretty weird, actually, and I hope I am very much mistaken. One reason for that is, of course, one reason that I would like to be mistaken, of course, is that one of said bosses is currently over there tangling with Domerik, and I don't really dare let him keep going like that. So yeah, so this is, go tell them a new one. Almost. Ah, and Hedva is there because she needs some of those heals. Ah, look at that. She can deparalyze Smeon. Great. That's what we need. Not quite ready to call an MVP yet, but nope. We needed that. Hera. Oh shit. Rogan needs healing urgently. And very fortunate that I could reach him. Yikes. Okay, Arthur, you can stay there and be ready to... No, actually... There. Now, Arthur can be at the ready to rumble. Waltz, let's see. I will put near here. I do want those lovely experience points for myself. And I get the Revenge Mace. If you remember from Scenario 1, well, getting the Revenge Mace pretty much broke the game. I've been defeated. Domerik has defeated me. I left the Empire 20 years ago, and now it is my time to die. Syos, Syos, strike our enemies down. Avenge me. And Jade receives the Revenge Mace. Ah, good. The battle continues. Don't scare me like that, Riders. I'll just remove that line so it doesn't confuse me anymore. Um, You'll be okay. Jesus. Ow. Well, this has been a very interesting fight. I will say that much. Let's see, can I do this? Yes, I can! Oh, I'm so wicked. So this may be another slightly short episode. I just meant to have some fun drinking tea and whatever. The episode ends when it ends. I thought I would find that more literal piece somewhere else, actually. So I was a little thrown off there. Let's see, Hasuki, how are you doing on items? Let me check stuff. Let's see, there's nothing there. Well, she does have range and movement, so I might as well bring her into the fight there. No. This should be enough. Going to do this. Well, first of all, we heal Domerik because he needs it. And Domerik, please don't be gung-ho. Let me clear these ruins. Okay. Arthur moves before Waltz. Remember this. Or I will try to remember this. Good. Feudal, I will keep here on the outside of the tomb with Medion. Because Medion can't move in there. I wonder if there's some kind of item up there. Up where Sios isn't, frankly. But to get up there, I will need to take some time. I mean, it will take me some time to actually get there. Oh, wait. Yeah, I just moved me also. Right, let's go in there right now. Yeah. Treasure will be yours. Fuck that. We ain't having that. Blah, 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 blah. Yada, yada. We'll let them, do whatever they want. I actually have 3 ranged units. I don't think that's the proper way. So we have Herald there. Well, they won't need anything in the ruins, will they? The healing, I mean. Hello. You can do this, right? Of course you can. Yeah. Bernard, I have no idea why he is so good, but he is, and that is the reality of the situation. And yeah, I have words to express my displeasure at seeing ambush spawns. Ah. Well, this is interesting. Domerek seems to follow me around. Or Mirion. That makes the AI a lot easier to game. Guys, don't stop for the mooks. Okay. Here we go. Someone needs to stand on the floor switch. I guess that might as well be Hedvan. This would be the full switch. Charge! Charge of the Arthur Brigade! Let's look at the map here though. Okay, there's one chest. There's a great big hole, I'm guessing that'll be the exit for the thief. There's another chest. Okay. No stopping on the door rails, apparently. Okay. Sleeped and wrecked. Those are some uncharacteristically bad growths out of you, Mr. Man. Okay. I will send Bernard to check this stone for any items. And the rest of us will carry on, regardless. Uh-huh. Thank you, game. So, there is an item in this rock here. The one the High Priest is staring at. Good to know. Let's see. Okay, you can leave there. Make sure it's safe to put Jade there. Don't Rick. Don't do this to me. Okay, Thiefy Poo, what are you gonna do? Honest here. Honest here in the chest. Right. You will stay there. I wonder, can I hurt the thief? Somehow. Yes, I can. Ha! Sweet. Okay, I'll have to remember that, and hopefully it will work out. Medion, do you have inventory space? Well, you have that medical herb that we don't really care about. Okay, so Synthesis got to check out that rock instead of the others. Fair enough. How about some of this? Almost, but hey, level up. And Spark level 2. Now you don't need the Evil Ring. Except to conserve MP. And a special attack. That's kind of nice. Eeny, meeny, miny, monkey. I only really saw not so good choices there. Speaking of, don't kill Jade. Oh, good. The tank is tanky. God damn it, Domerik. Stop doing that. Well, at least it's not getting killed, so there's that. But Okay, they're all moving in line. They keep staying ahead of the pursuers. That is good. Look at that, look at that. Great. There's no way at all that Arthur is going to take all those, kill this guy in one shot. Or even two. And there you go. Okay, one more goddess tier to the Shining Force. And you can just raid the rock in advance and chuck that one. No spark level 2 here. Price just moves so much. Let's see, wasn't there something about the pretty glove? No, that was a different glove. Okay. Well, we're just hanging around here with Hera. Trouble? Well. Okay, first rats, people. I should have gone for the High Priest instead of the Megaloader. Stupidity confirmed. Does anyone need healing? You're good. You're good, you are good, we are all good. So, wait, what the hell is Urgh supposed to be doing? Right, he does have that bit of attack magic. Rogan, don't do this to me. Don't charge the boss. Well, they are forming up. That's good. God Rapier. Wow, that has a nice ring to it. Let's get that. Arthur? I guess Hedva could have moved off the thing there. Shut the thief in, but this worked out well. We have the God Rapier, and that's pretty much it for the ruins. Once the thief leaves, yeah. We are set. Let's see, there might be something in this rock. And there's nothing up there. Okay, good. We don't need no antidote herb. Okay. Well, that I'll need her for healing. I think I'll actually send Hera to check on the rock there and its item. Good, Cyrus is moving. I don't think he'll trigger until we cross the bridges. Say that the Royal Guard has the situation well in hand. Just, still don't charge the boss, please. Okay, then we are out of the ruins. Goody goody. Right. A dark matter is what we are looking for. And. Can I do this? Oh, you know I have to try. I will regret it, I know. But hey, it's smart build too. Okay, so can a... Oh no, we don't like that. Well, snap. That's... Well... God damn it. Game. Well, and... Dark Matter. People are going to be hurt on the next turn. That's just... That's a fact. Let's see... That does lower your defense, but can you cast... No, you can't. Well, piss. Stay alive, please. Okay. This is fine. We can still salvage this. I think. Whew. Okay, only 5 damage. Great. Pro strats. So Medion will be using some of his healing items for the next couple of turns. Right, we came out on that side of things. Okay, so I got it wrong. Imagine that. Medion back to full. Fabled tag team is on the move. Before ruining Silas' day, I think it would be a good idea to thin out the numbers there. So I will do that. What she said, definitely. Okay, so let's get started on the boss then. That took a lot less time than I was expecting. High priest is going to be annoying, isn't he? it just feels ridiculous to see such a character designed, like the tank gunner in mostly medieval-themed video game like this one. At least if you're me. Okay. It should be fine. And we can send someone to deal with the High Priest. And, Domeric, you can please stay right where you are. Medion, you are not countering. Ow. That hurt. Right, let's deal with this guy first, with Medion. Oh, it's gonna be a one-shot kill. Oh, wait, it's that other... special thing. Okay. Glad we cleared that up. Now we can take you. And how's we can go ham on Sayos? Perfect. Wow. I have no idea what my team has been smoking, but We are doing good. Only the boss left. Let's see what we can do. Actually, let's equip the golem rod again. And, yep, that should deal a bit more damage than freeze. Okay. Spell. The stun bomb. No. Well, that backfired. Don't kill the boss, please. Leave him for me. I'm the player here. You're not. You don't need the XP. Meat shield. Please. Wait. Domerick. Please spare my life. Why should I let you live, Sios? I'm defeated. You can see that. Let's put the past aside. What? You set a trap for me and planned my destruction only to suffer a crushing defeat, and now you plead for your life. I want to return to Dystonia, back to Imperial Law. I promise to quietly spend my remaining years there. It amuses me to see you squirm like a bug, Sios. You had the Emperor under your thumb, but now that your bid for victory has failed, you can only beg for mercy. Silence, Fidret. I am talking to the Emperor, and I have a question to ask. Usually you have the Rainbloods with you, Domerick. Why would you not bring them to this battle? The Rainbloods were not needed to overcome this ambush. And if my suspicions about the timeline is correct, they are currently doing something else entirely. We will meet them again in Scenario 3. Follow up on that little sub-story. So the Rainblood Assassins aren't with you. Why? Are they wiping out some other poor sacrifice elsewhere? Speaking of which... why wouldn't they be here? They would have killed me before I could have laid a finger on Emperor Domerick, murdering me like a dog. Dispose of Sios, Midian. I ask you to dispose of the enemy. Why do you pause? Will you do as I say? Well, the humanitarian in me would say no here, but I mean, it is fair. To say yes here. I mean, within the context of the game world, I'm just going to go and say yes. I don't think people will like it though, but... and they will misconstrue my reasoning, but... I mean, people in the game. As it should be, Prince Midian. You heard the Emperor's order. Strike him down. Don't let him get away, Midian. I will not permit this resistance. If you will not act, then Campbell, dispose of Sios. Obey your emperor, Campbell. Since the prince hesitates, you will carry out the order instead. Masha, kill him. So, yeah, okay. I was wondering if you'd encountered any problems, Yasha. It's good to see you're still alive. Now, leave us. What was that head shaking about? Before you can become a great leader, you must learn to act when necessary, Media. To recapture the Republic, I must always take the proper course of action, whether you agree or not. Sios was Lord of Swampland. There could be danger for us there, Federate. Yes, Emperor. We will have to keep watch for any threats. Time to go, Minion. Hehe. Let's not waste any more time here. We head for Swampland Castle. I should have reacted quicker to the Emperor's order. I must not give pause next time. As we get closer to Aspia, in a delicate operation like this one, the Median army will need to carry out its orders to the letter. If the prince's army offers passive resistance to Emperor Domeric's plans, I understand we must follow orders, but what about the consequences? Prince Median, if you refuse to carry out his orders, the Emperor will hold you back. And think back to the ending of Scenario 1 now, and the implications of this little conversation to the events that played out there. Prince, even if you don't agree with this invasion, I believe you must yield to your father and do as he says. Fuck that, honestly. He's a jerk. Now, we can pass through this cavern to Swampland. Then we will have to get past the Eastern Mountains. Let's hurry, Prince Median. The Emperor was rescued, but Garvin and Arant escaped. The Median army pursued them, but were intercepted by Lord Sios and Lord Daka. Prince Median was victorious, but resented Emperor Domeric's treatment of the defeated. And that's the end of Chapter 5. And, yeah. When we return, it will be Chapter 6, a very eventful chapter, it seems like. Many battles to get through, no less than 5, actually. And yeah, I will see you in Chapter 6, pretty much. Bye for now.